as people are talking about this virus, especially since we've seen in other countries that it can become widespread, like in Italy, there's this notion of flattening the curve or flattening the wave. And what that's referring to is if you think about a wave sort of coming through an area and then moving past the area, think of the wave or the curve as being the number of patients in the community that actively have that infection. Well, a certain small percentage of the people that have that active infection could become more ill and require healthcare services. And so if the wave is very big, then there will proportionally be more people that need healthcare services. And what we want to do is try and flatten the wave so that it's within the capacity of our community's healthcare system to handle anything that comes our way, whether it's sick kids that have cough and cold and need attention, or whether it's somebody that's very ill and needs to be in the hospital and treated for pneumonia. So when people hear about that flatten the curve or flatten the wave concept, that's the idea with why we think about social distancing, is the more we can slow down transmission of this virus, the slower the onset in the community of this infection, and the more capacity we have as a system to care for everybody's needs as it happens. That's why we're seeing all these changes with the Big 12 canceling tournaments, the NBA canceling games, Iowa State moving online. Everybody's trying to think through in their particular way, how do we thoughtfully decrease the risk of transmission in our community so that we can flatten that wave and prevent going beyond the capacity of our system. There's no question that there's downsides to that process, whether it's sporting events being canceled, students moving online, normal organizations not getting to meet the way they should. We humans, we are social beings, and we do best when we're together with each other. I think we need to just figure this out thoughtfully together. How do we move through this time? How do we flatten the wave? And then as we come out of it on the other side, then how do we start re-engaging those different things in a meaningful and thoughtful way? That's the balance I think everyone's trying to strike. And I think every organization is different, and just trying to be careful and thoughtful with what they can do to prevent spread of this virus.